We're proud to present you with this virtual, hands-only CPR training in partnership with the American Heart Association and Methodist Healthcare System. Our shared goal is to train 10,000 members of our community, so thank you for helping us get closer to our goal. The American Heart Association recommends hands-only CPR for teens and adults who suddenly collapse. By the end of this training, you will be able to share how to learn hands-only CPR by watching a fun 60-second video, talk about when to use hands-only CPR, and know what to do when you call 911. What is CPR? CPR stands for cardiopulmonary resuscitation. By pushing hard and fast on someone's chest, you are acting as their external heart. By doing so, you're helping to pump blood to the vital organs, such as the brain. So, what is hands-only CPR? Hands-only CPR is CPR without mouth-to-mouth breaths. It just takes two steps to save a life. Number one, call 911. And two, push hard and fast in the center of the chest at least 100 to 120 times per minute until the person responds or emergency personnel arrive. Hands-only CPR, CPR with just chest compressions, has been proven to be as effective as CPR with breaths in the first few minutes of an out-of-hospital sudden cardiac arrest. So, what is cardiac arrest? When someone collapses and stops breathing, they are most likely in cardiac arrest. This is when the heart stops beating. Cardiac arrest is triggered by an electrical malfunction that causes the heart to have an irregular beat. When the heart doesn't beat, it cannot pump blood to the brain, lungs, and other vital organs. It may be abrupt and unexpected. It can happen to anyone at any time. Did you know that 7 out of 10 cardiac arrests occur at a home or residence? This means that the life you save may be a loved one. With all of us spending more time at home right now, this is more important than ever. How can you tell the difference between cardiac arrest versus a heart attack? A heart attack is a circulation problem. Blood flow to the heart is blocked. When a person is having a heart attack, they are usually talking to you, grabbing their arm, telling you where they are feeling discomfort. You do not need to administer CPR on a person that is having a heart attack. You just need to call 911 and get them to the hospital as soon as possible. Cardiac arrest is an electrical problem. The heart malfunctions and suddenly stops beating. When a person is in cardiac arrest, they are not talking to you, they are not responsive, and not breathing. That is why you must act fast, call 911, and start compressions. You can think of a heart attack as a plumbing problem and cardiac arrest as an electrical problem. Just to reiterate, cardiac arrest is when the heart stops beating. It is not a heart attack. But a heart attack may cause cardiac arrest. Only 1 of 10 people who suffer cardiac arrests out of the hospital will survive. Cardiac arrest can happen to anyone at any time. Sadly, a very small percentage of people who go into cardiac arrest outside of the hospital live, only about 10%. That's only 1 in 10 of our loved ones who survive. And victims may seem perfectly fine. They appear to be healthy. They may not have any previous known problems with their heart. Want to know why every minute is so critical? Did you know that for every minute that passes without CPR, a person's chance of survival decreases by 10%? That means if you wait 5 to 7 minutes for EMS to arrive, that person's chance of survival has already decreased by 50 to 70%. I want to reiterate what I said earlier. Hands-only CPR should only be administered on adults or teens who suddenly collapse and stop breathing. It is not for use with infants and young children. Traditional CPR needs to be used with babies and small children. Have you ever had to call 911? Does the thought of doing so make you nervous? After you dial 911, stay on the phone until the dispatcher provides further instruction. Remember, if you are in a group of people, point and directly assign someone to call 911. If you are alone, simply dial 911 and put it on speakerphone. As a bystander, don't be afraid. Your actions can only help. Remember, when you come across someone who has suddenly collapsed, your first step in performing CPR is to call 911. They'll ask you about the emergency. They'll ask you details about the location. Be specific. This is especially true when calling from your mobile phone, because the physical address of where you are is not linked to your phone number. For example, don't just give the address. Give the address and instructions on how to reach you. I'm on the second floor to the right, or I'm in apartment building 4. Take a right inside the complex. And lead them to you with specific instructions. Every minute is critical. If you speak Spanish only, tell the dispatcher, "Heart stopped, Spanish interpreter." Answering the dispatcher's questions will not delay the arrival of help. Remain on the line until the dispatcher tells you it's okay to hang up. We're about to watch a brief video that will help us prepare to act if someone suddenly collapses. Only 30% of our community is prepared to act in an emergency situation. 70% are not prepared to act, don't know CPR, or their training has lapsed, making them uncomfortable to respond. We're about to change that and empower you to save a life.
If you see a teen or adult suddenly collapse, it's important to act fast. Helping to save a life is easier than you might think. Just start hands-only CPR. The first step is to send someone to call 911 or call 911 yourself. Then get directly over the victim. Put the heel of one hand in the center of the chest, then put your other hand on top of the first. Then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. It's important to push, giving 100 to 120 compressions per minute, which is about the same tempo as the song Stayin' Alive. Let's hope you never have to use hands-only CPR. But if you see a teen or adult suddenly collapse, don't be afraid to try it. Remember, call 911, then push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. Your actions can help save a life.
Let's review some of the common questions that people have when learning hands-only CPR. I'm sure you're already thinking about some of these yourself. Can I get into legal trouble for performing CPR? Have you heard of the Good Samaritan Law? They vary from state to state, but the good news is that here in Texas, as long as you are rendering aid, you are protected. What if someone has an injury? Can I make the situation worse by doing CPR? No. A person whose heart stopped must have CPR to survive. Your willingness to help by administering hands-only CPR can only help. I only watched a short video. I have no other formal training. What if I do it wrong? Without CPR, this person will not survive. Your actions will only help. You are their best chance of survival. You must remember, a doctor can fix a broken bone. He cannot always bring someone back to life. So, what if someone collapses and I'm worried they have COVID-19? Can I still perform CPR? The answer is yes. Simply protect your face with a mask or face covering and do the same to the person receiving CPR. Cover their face with a mask or cloth. Call 911 and begin compressions. Okay, so let's review the two steps to save a life. Number one, call 911. Number two, push hard and fast in the center of the chest until help arrives. Make sure you are administering at least 100 to 120 compressions per minute. You want to administer compressions until either emergency help arrives or the person becomes responsive. Please share what you've learned today. Give 5 people you care about the power to save lives. Ask them to watch the hands-only CPR video. Thank you for listening. Now it's time to practice. For more information about matters of the heart, visit sahealth.com/heart.